Hi everybody, my name is Ibrahim. I'm one of the streamer community members. I have joined this community since 2017 and now I'm delighted to be here to talk to you about our community product Surface Streamer. Before I go through the capabilities of the Surface Streamer, I would like to give you some background information about our project. In January 22nd, Henry introduced the concept of community products. In my opinion, this idea is brilliant and it creates a win-win-win situation for developers, data producers, and data consumers. Just 1 week later, I contacted the streamer team and we talked about our idea. They were positive about the idea and we start our journey by developing a proof of concept for the idea. In POC, we shows that how we could capture user search query and send this query to the marketplace. Let me show you a short video of the POC. We go to google.com and search for, this is a search on Google. As you see, a message containing search query has been sent to a streamer. After sharing the video with the streamer team, we got some interesting comment from the team and they mentioned some corner cases. The first step of our development was about designing Surface Streamer engine. We designed a multi-layer engine for Surface Streamer. At the lowest level, we have modules. A module is a combination of some relative data collectors. These collectors collect user browsing activities. At the next level, we let the user choose which collector could send data to marketplace. At the third level, we designed a filtering mechanism that gives user the ability to exclude domains and URLs that their data are not going to be sent to marketplace. The last layer is about user privacy. With the help of this layer, we transform all data based on their type and the level of the privacy that user have been chosen. Okay, let's show you a demo of Surface Streamer. When you install the Surface Streamer, an icon will be added at the right corner of your browser. By clicking the icon, a pop-up menu will appear. You can see your wallet ID and wallet balance and enable and disable streaming data to marketplace. I click on the setting icon to show you how we can configure the Surface Streamer. As you see, a page is open in the browser, and in this page, there is a site navigation with some items. The first item of site navigation is profile. In profile, we configure wallet ID and email address. Email address is an optional, and you can leave this blank. The next item of sidebar navigation is filters. Let me show you how we can easily exclude a domain by adding a new filter. I enter https://star.streamer.com/star as value and wildcard as type and then save. Now I go to streamer.com. As you see, the icon show that module is disabled. Now I go to marketplace, module is disabled again. I remove the filter. As you see, the module will be enabled. Okay, the next item we are going to talk about is modules. We have designed two types of modules, built-in modules and marketplace modules. We are not going to talk about marketplace modules in this video. We implemented six built-in modules, Amazon module, Facebook module, search, surfing, Twitter, and YouTube module. In this video, we just talk about search module. A module has a name, a description, a URL, an icon, and a switch for enabling and disabling the module. When we disable the module, nothing will be sent to marketplace through the module, even if some collector of the module have been enabled. A module is a combination of some relative collectors. As you see, in this module, we have search query, search result, click link, and adds click link as collector for search module and Google search engine category. Search module has more categories: Yahoo search engine category, AOL search engine, Bing search engine, Ask search engine, and Baidu search engine. Each category in search module has its own data collectors. Now let me show you how these data collectors could help us to collect data about searching activities of users on top 6 search engines. Before showing the demo, we go to Profile menu to enable Delay Sending Messages option. We set 10 minutes for delay and then save changes. It helps us to see the messages before sending to Marketplace in Messages menu. Now let's navigate to google.com and search for best laptops 2019. This is the search result for our query. And if we get back to Surface Streamer, we can see two messages that has been received. The first message is from Google Query Collector, and it shows that we searched for best laptops 2019 in web category. And the next message is about our search result that has been collected by Google search result. The data for this message is search result, and search ad results, ads results. And for search result, we collected link, title, description, and rank. And also for ads result, we collected link, title, description, and rank of the ads. Now we'll remove the messages, and these messages will never go to Streamer Marketplace. Again, we get back to search result and we click on a link. On Surface Streamer, we can see a new message. This message is collected by Google Click Link Collector, and the data for message is rank, link, title, query, page number, and category. Okay, we remove the message and get back to search result. And now we click on an add in this page. And let's see, the add result has been received. The collector for this message is Google Ads Click Link, and the rank, link, title, query, page number, and category has been captured for this message. Okay, we remove the message. The last thing we are going to talk about in this video is about our privacy mechanism. Each module has a privacy level that we can be configured by user. To show you how the privacy mechanism works, we have developed a simple tools. The privacy mechanism works based on two factors: privacy level and data type. We have identified some data type for data that has been sent to Marketplace. We identify URL, time, time string, text, ID, user info, and user attribute as data type. And for privacy level, we have privacy level at lowest and low, medium, high, and highest. Lowest privacy level, data will be sent to Marketplace without any changes. As you see, the URL value before privacy enforcement and after privacy enforcement are equal. At low privacy level, we do a simple transformation on each item of data that has been sent to Marketplace. As an example, for URLs, we remove all query strings at the URL path. In this example, var1 and var2 has been nullified. For time string, we have removed minutes and seconds of the time. And for text data type, we mask surface streamer that has been identified as a protected data. And ID, user ID, and user attribute data types has been hashed using a simple hash algorithm. At medium privacy level, for text data type, we replace surface streamer with stars. And for timer strings, we remove the hours. For the URL, the path has been masked. You can also see the changes for high privacy level. And at the highest privacy level, as you see, ID, user info, and user attribute has been removed. And for the time string, it just shows the year of the time. And for the URL, URL path, and query string has been removed. For further information about our privacy model, you can navigate to manual menu and see the table regarding the privacy model and get more information about privacy levels and data types. In case you have any question, don't hesitate to ask me by sending me an email or drop a line in Twitter. Okay, that's it. Thank you for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed this.